So there are all these amazing hands and knees exercises where you place your palm down and you can do all sorts of great stuff from breathing to bird dogs. But what if the wrist is too painful to be able to put it down or weight bear for long periods of time? So maybe you've tried the little rings or assisted holders where you don't have to press your wrist flat. Maybe you tried putting a towel roll under your wrist to kind of take off some of that pressure from being able to bring your fingers back. So some of those can be great modifications, but if you've gotten to know me by now, you know I love tackling a problem more head on than I do with coming up with adaptations for it. Now, being a rock climber makes me very acutely aware of the health of my hand and wrist so that I can continue climbing for a very long period of time. So one of the things that I've noticed was working with women and men that end up with wrist pain with weight bearing is that they often cannot open their thenar eminence. So what I want you to do now is take a look at your wrist, take a look at your palm, and I want you to open up your palm flat. And oh, this is hard for me. It's very, very tight from lots of climbing and not stretching enough after, but or working the opposition muscles enough, I should add. But I want you to take a look at how flat this thenar eminence is. So one of the common exercises for helping to open or deal with wrist pain on hands and knees is a band exercise where you open against resistance of a rubber band. Now, when I ask people who are still having wrist pain to show me how they do this exercise, it almost always looks like this. Okay, do you note how I'm not getting my palm open and I still have a valley here? Okay, so it doesn't really do us much good at all to do this exercise without going through the full range, because when we place our palms flat on the ground, we have to go through that full range of motion. So if you do that exercise and never go through the full range of motion, you're not getting the benefit. So what I want you to do, grab a rubber band, join me with this. I feel like this is just so healthy for that CMC joint, for our best of our lives, for not having pain here. But what I want you to do is pretend that you are a bear attacking people, and I want you to think about opening your wrist, opening your fingers in that claw-like motion, but you're gonna open from the palm, making sure you don't hyperextend fingers. So oftentimes I'll see people that'll end up hyperextending here. But what I want you to work on is opening in that subtle kind of like, I'm gonna growl at you motion, and open the entire palm. So you should have a nice, flat thenar eminence where you're working on getting that thumb open instead of keeping it here and just moving the fingers. So give that a shot. You may find that feels incredibly weak, where you're like, wow, I found extensor muscles that I never knew I had, and that will help balance out that system, especially helpful if you're getting any carpal tunnel issues or just you can't press your wrist down to do hands and knees. So work on that for a couple weeks, really opening in here. And if you feel like there's no way I can't even get it open without resistance, then I want you to be your own massage therapist and massage out this area, thinking about opening and flattening as you massage through those tissues, and see if you can get that to open a little bit more, and then follow it with your rubber band exercise, getting it to open. And then you may find after a couple weeks of doing this several times per week that you have a lot more relief with being able to put your palms flat down on the ground.